Oh, what are the scary parts? Giant fish in a foggy area and I can't see it and it's trying to eat me. There's a mod to just remove it from the game and I was ecstatic and going, I could do that. The high artist. Hello, Daz. Hey, Masu. Yeah. Hello, Toxin. Great to see you guys again. Just loads into the game and it's just the credits. Now that would be sad, but also funny. So I ran this earlier and it worked. Got to run it again now. This is how he'll remind me of a giant fish. Oh, I didn't put up my model. If we get one gift sub or any sub at all, I will put webcam on. Like I did yesterday. Same rules apply. Resume. Sure if it'll put me where I was. No, not a 12-hour stream though. That's not happening. I have to work tomorrow. Let's see, mods. See, light bramble. Look at that. Table fish, table frog. But artists, thank you for the 5 gift subs. Okay. All right. I could put that back on again. Hello, once again, Wacky Funny Man is back. Also, if you
Hi,
guys
I'm
missed it
Chucky,
the other
and
day,
I'm your friend
there's
to the
Nicolas
end.
Cage right
Artist
there.
underscore Kane
Say hi
gifted
to
a
Nick.
tier one sub to Nyx.
Not me. There's Nicolas Cage right there. This cage pillow.
Hi, I'm Chucky,
For those of you that
and I'm
needed
your
to know
friend to
or
the
not
end.
know,
Artist underscore Kane gifted a tier one sub to Beaky.
I'm a big Nicolas Cage fan, and someone got me that as like a joke. I mean, it's just a pillowcase. I still find it funny. Alright, so I need to show you guys what it looks like there, because I did test it on my own.
Hi,
Just to see how
I'm Chucky, and I'm your friend to the end.
Artist underscore Kane gifted a tier
and
one sub
I
to the
swear,
Bat
I don't
Badger.
know if the person who made the mod used like Legend of Zelda music for it or what, but listen to the music when we go in there now. Also, man, I'm happy I didn't make this the first planet I would try to go to.
Hi, I'm Chucky,
just
and I'm
experience.
Your friend to the end.
Artist underscore Kane gifted a tier one sub to Four Trunks Recon.
Thank you again, by the way, artist, for this. Appreciate it very much.
Hi, I'm Chucky, and I'm your friend to the end.
Artist underscore Kane gifted a tier one sub to Summer underscore Afternoon underscore.
Thank you, warm thoughts all. All so nice to each other. All right, here we go. The mod is enabled, so let's go in there. Find out. Oh shit! I went too fast. I forgot how how funny the deaths can be in here. Dying in this is still hilarious. That's one of the reasons why they were like, oh, we could just make it scary, because if somebody, you know, knows that they can't die to it, maybe then they won't have any fear of it. It's like, no, I'm still have a huge fear of it. Hey, Reed. Oh, I have to show you guys all the memes that Reed made for yesterday's stream, too, because I didn't do that. He drives a car real slow. Apparently, if you get too close, apparently, you just die. I like going fast in games. That's because I am not the one actually, you know, in the car, or in the vehicle. Then you must be asking, Bizarros, doesn't that mean that you'd be okay with, like, your character getting eaten by a giant fish? No. Because I still feel empathy to some degree, and that would still freak me out. Hi, Rosie! Hello. What if it was a third-person game? You'd be okay with your character being eaten by a giant fish there? No, actually, maybe. It is kind of that Resident Evil thing, right? You know how they made it third person? I guess. Alright. Zyro Slaughter compared. Is the game Slaughter compared to Zyro's? I could turn it down. Look at it. Look at this place. Look at how much different it looks without the fog everywhere. What are those dang fish? This is definitely Legend of Zelda music, isn't it? That's what it sounds like to me. Like, this sounds like Deku Tree straight up. I heard you guys talking about the music being loud, and let me change the out-of-game volume. Did that help at all? Because I don't know why. Like, is this something to do with the mod itself? Messing with the music because of that? Still loud to me. Like, music's all the way at nothing. Listen to that. Definitely something that affects it outside of that. The Deku Tree is very loud. Deku Tree, why are you so loud? I went swimming in the ocean in a touristy area once. The water was murky and a big ass fish swam about 5 inches from my face. Needless to say, I was done swimming. That. See? Not just me. This is a thing that a lot of people don't like. What is this? Hello, whatever you are. Like, I think it, without the fog, even if I saw the fish now, that would be okay. But it was the fact that I couldn't see them anywhere, and I had to just rely on all these bright lights. Are these angler fish eggs? Probably. Be my guess. What's in here? Find the zone would make it so much less anxiety inducing for me. Same, Chow. Is there a toggle in the mod for the music? Yes, actually there is. Spot music. I could turn that off if I wanted to. Am I just going in a circle now? Bro, this place is crazy. Like, you didn't need all this other stuff in here. You just needed this. And this whole zone is just nuts. Is it? I think every time I go through one of these, it, like, teleports me around, you know? Kind of like if I was in, like, the Kokiri forest. Oh, okay. Follow this distress beacon noise. Those lost woods. Yeah, it's... plays a lot like The Lost Woods, right? You need to follow the noise to know where to go. That's how I found that one guy. Whoa. From like over here-ish. There it is. The area looks so small without the fog. Not only does it look small, it seems a lot more approachable. Our escape pod crashed as we tried to flee this place, destroying our movement and communication capabilities in the process. We've held out as long as we could here, but this pod's supply of breathable air is nearly depleted and the anglerfish attack more frequently. The best chance of survival is to return to the vessel to either repair the damage or more probably wait rescue. Seka, is the message finished? The vessel's beacon is already growing fainter. It will be gone in a matter of hours. We need an identified signal nearby. Just beacon, but I knew it was like right over here. You go in and. I figured that there would be one of these here. There we go. Okay. The game's happy with that. We can go on and keep exploring this place. Escape pod 3. Vessel has been mortally injured. Emergency sequence activated, awaiting departure from vessel. Now launching escape pod 3. Multiple collisions have altered pod's trajectory. Significant damage to pod detected. Navigation error, life support error, propulsion error. Incomplete gravity not detected, breathable air not detected, multiple life forms detected, potentially hostile. Verdict, do not exit pod. Anglerfish. Gotta tell me to not exit the pod. New problem, our equipment is detecting two distinct beacons from the vessel, but it isn't possible for the vessel to be in two different locations at the same time. We found out that it is kind of okay for that to happen. I agree, but the beacons are exactly identical to each other. Perhaps if I had more time. We're nearly out of time already. Din, the vessel's beacon is quickly fading. Soon it will be lost. It will be gone and we will be lost. We will follow the beacon whose source is nearest to us. But suppose that beacon is false. We likely don't have enough air to reach the farther of the two beacons, Din. The decision is made for us. We'll leave a trail of lights as we go. There's still a chance someone could hear our escape pod's distress signal. That was us. Heard that. Then follow the lights. How lucky for me there's no giant fish.
Base.
Oh. Oh. I see. Look like they made it, huh? Funny you come here searching for us. We followed one of the two beacons from the vessel to this place, but we can go no further. Almost too faint to hear now, but the vessel's beacon is still faintly emitting from within this thorny seed, yet the opening is too small for even a single gnome to fit through it. Our escape pod couldn't have flown through here. I don't understand how this could be possible, but this gruesome place seems able to manipulate space itself. Maybe this is our undoing. Be so close to the location of the vessel and still so far is worse, the vessel's beacon is dying. Soon we will be able to hear it. Hi, Junichi. There's nothing we can do now but try to perhaps find a way inside, or at least attempt to comprehend why this happened. My dearest hope is that the other escape pods were able to reach relative safety. Yeah, kind of, but kind of not. Sadly. Where's my scout? My scouty do? Can I just go in it? Oh. No, I cannot just go in it. Where's my scout? Hold on. sometimes if I just do
this. What's this? What's this?
That was loud. Crystallic, thank you for that follow. Alright. And go. Duplicate signal. Oh, there's the duplicate signal over there. So if I go through the red one, we should be able to reach it. Where's the ship at? Yo, ship. Where you at? Thank you for that follow and welcome. Oh, this is so much better though, without having to deal with all the worry of, you know, murderous fish. You find it funny that the music cuts out unless you're in here. Let's go to the red one, I guess. Is this your first playthrough? Yes, I tried going through this zone and I was not prepared for the angler fish. And considering it was like my biggest phobia, I said no. I was not dealing with that. Thankfully, I think a lot of people feel the same way, so they removed it. Why is there Ocarina of Time music in here? Because I'm assuming the music that actually plays in this zone is probably more tense, fitting the fact that you have to get through a bunch of really creepy things in here. Can I change your stream tags or nay? Yeah, you can change them. Wait, no, you can't. Why? What do you want me to put in there? I don't think you can. More like Majora's Mask. Sounds like the Deku Tree song, doesn't it? Hi, Cor. The Zelda music is a little loud. So, you got the VTuber tag. Oh, let me take that off, actually. We don't need that on right now. So the thing with the Zelda music is that it's not tied to the game music. If you notice, like, the game sound is actually kind of low since I lowered it. People were saying it was kind of loud. It is tied to the mod itself. Strange. Like, I could turn it off if people think it's too loud. Hello, my scout. That's a lot of skeletons. I was just very confused. No, it's all just part of a mod to make people feel more comfortable. Instead of going through here and being scared like I was, because I did not enjoy that at all. This is fine. Oh. I used to hate Dark Bramble. How'd you get over it, just going through it enough, or if you don't like that, then I'd say stay away from the DLC. That's hilarious. Someone told me I should get it, and I'm like, I don't know about that. If it's the same with more anglerfish, no thank you. I'm good. I'm good, Holmes. This. What's that do? Nothing. Take it this way. Oh. So if we bring that thing here, we could put it in there. This. Well, what I did was just didn't play with my lights off in the middle of the night and blasted my own music, you know? Sure. Might be okay with the DLC. Yeah, the biggest thing for me was having to deal with seeing them actually, like an enemy pursuing you to, like, consume you, and also traveling through the darkness to just see them and having to just accept traveling through nothing. Did I find the lore that tells you how to get around them? Yeah, but it's just dealing with that was spooky to me. Is what it came down to. It's my one biggest phobia and I couldn't do anything about it. It's just not fun. He didn't find the lore. I thought I did. Did I not find anything on the anglerfish? Or was I just too frightened to do anything and that just happened to be the correct strategy? Don't do anything and you'll be okay. Yeah. Yeah. Like, I tried to do it yesterday and I just couldn't. Like, I had my face like this, keeping myself away from looking at the screen. And I actually scared more people than I meant to, because I immediately, like, I just did what people said, where they're like, oh, you just go forward. You know, just hold your thruster forward for a second, and then just let yourself, you know, drift off. I decided to do that, and then we ended up bumping directly into an anglerfish, I guess. But I had my game muted, like, noise muted, so I didn't know what was going on. Ugh. Okay. So, we need to get that warp doodad and bring it over here. And then something can happen, then. Let's try that. How do we get out of here? Hey, Yama. Bro, that is such a weird planet. I don't think we'll have enough time to get through there, but hey, who knows?
Peace.
Yeah, it seems like things are about to explode. Namely us. Bye, everyone. Is that the second time I've done that? No. Third, I think. How's Outer Wilds treating us? Oh, very good. Just saw we just sort of slowly veered into the sun. Everything else, even Giant's Deep didn't freak me out, and that's just a giant, like, ocean. I was fine with that. It was all the fog and not being able to see anything and just knowing that those lights were probably just, like, things lurking in the dark. I was like, uh-uh. Oh, thank you. Let's go get the warp core thing first. Get the warp core, we take it there, and then something happens. Sure of it. But dang, this game is fun. Such a cool experience to just sort of float around like this. Funny enough, we did take the warp core with us there, and then we got ate by a fish, and the game rolled the credits to be like, yeah, you died because you took the warp core, and yeah, the game's over. Or, you know, the reason that you stopped the Ash Twin project from working, so the memory thing isn't working anymore. I was like, oh, okay. Makes sense. This might be the most unique playthrough I've ever watched so far. Unique how? Oh. Abort. Abort for a second. Don't run to the other planet. Ending mode. Stumbled across the solution to three things that most people take forever to work out. I have a good habit of just falling onto things. Anyone else singing Space Odyssey by David Bowie while he flies in the stars? Good. No, I saw someone dressed as David Bowie for Halloween. I don't know why that was just a random thing that happened. And a Pikachu. I think I mentioned that one. It was a giant Pikachu. Ah. Hey, Coca. We're going to be playing Trombone Champ later. I got a whole bunch of songs. Some memes, some not. You know me. I love video game songs, so I found like a whole bunch of video game ones. 100% not cursed. I didn't use all the ones you sent me yet. Specifically, one. I don't know. I feel like if people saw it, most of them would be like, why? But it was fun. Hey. Just adrift. Which one? The frickin' was it? The Animal Crossing one. The Giant's Deep thing we found out just because I was like, what happens if I go into the tornadoes as a joke? And then it shot me underwater, and then I just went up to the jellyfish. I was like, oh, cool, you can go inside the jellyfish. We found the coordinates for the eye. And then I came here, and I talked to, I forgot what his name is, the explorer that's on this planet. And he told us about how, like, oh yeah, the sand, you know, it moves back and forth between the planets. And I was like, oh yeah, you know, I remember going in there when, because I had to downgrade my graphics driver so I could play this game properly. We went into that area inside the planet, and we were exploring and walking around. And we ended up finding, like, all those notes and things and stuff. Yeah, chert. But then, like, as you guys know, my graphics driver was bugging out, so I couldn't really explore it fully, but I tried my best to go exploring. But I noticed that the sand was, like, leaving and coming to that planet. So then I came out over this way to explore it and see what happens. And I noticed that, like, if you just kind of keep moving around, you'll see that there's, like, buildings that show up, right, from staying here. And I was like, okay, well, from falling into the black hole on accident and using the white hole station, I saw that the purple teleporter can actually take you places. I didn't know exactly how to make the teleporter work here. Someone kind of told me how to have it teleport you, which, I mean, I'm fine with, because it was just weird. It was like, oh, when the sand shows up, you need to move, like, as the sand is coming, but not before. And I was like, well, how would I ever figure that out? Maybe the game tells me somewhere, but I was like, that's too big brain for me. It was a note that I missed from not being in there. Yeah, I'm not gonna find that. Because I don't know. My experience with one of those areas got, well, very shortened because of that. But I did enjoy all the exploration and stuff that we've done. Game's neat. Game is neat. Forgot which one I'm supposed to take though. Is it left or the right one? It was this one over here. I have to wait for the sand to keep going down. Too high. Another reason why I'm happy that the anglerfish are gone. It would have taken me forever to ever find where to actually go in that area. One of my favorite things is just how crazy each of the planets are. They are very unique from each other. There's a lot of things that go on with each of them, you know. And I just think that's really cool, like you said. There's a lot going on. You have the planet that has the black hole in the center of it. You have this one. You have its twin planet, which is the one with the sand. You have the giant ocean planet, which... When I was looking at the Dark Bramble thing and I found the mod for it, I saw that a lot of people were actually more afraid of Giant's Deep too. Like, a lot of people were terrified of that section, which I understand, because that's more of people who have a problem with thalassophobia, which is the fear of, like, oceans, which I get. For me, I'm okay with it as long as I know that there's nothing in there. And I assumed none of these planets had anything in them. Which is why I was okay with it. When I saw the jellyfish, I was like, oh, jellyfish. They don't really do anything to anyone. Normally not hostile. Then I saw the anglerfish. And I pooped my pants. In frozen planet with eight AT-ATs. No speeders. Wampas? Yeah, I agree. We need more Wampa. I think he said as soon as, like, the sand starts to touch this, I move in. Not before. Like, as the sand comes over us. Like now. Nope. Nope. I did it wrong. Dang. Back down. Back to the planet. It's just so strange that I can't just wait on it. Is everyone having a good weekend so far? Enjoying themselves? Just remember that I have hot chocolate. Oh. Hot chocolate is so nice in this kind of weather. Wish I had hot chocolate. You know the exact time for this, Vero? Hot chocolate for the sand weather? Yeah, hot chocolate for the sand weather. The sand is about halfway through. As you guys know, I don't really mind backseating as long as it's something that I'm not getting. Probably 1 second after. Okay, we'll wait a little bit. Hot chocolate for like fall weather, you know what I meant. Also, our ship. Our ship. Real ship, man. Here we go. Okay. Well, then we can skip all of this because we know what this is. Moving around in this area is so weird. Love it. Was just funny. All that work just to get poked. Now to get back to the ship. The bit of a predicament. No flying at full speed into a planet again. Boy, I wanna. Where's my ship? Hey, ship. Ship, I'm coming. Ship, don't forget me. I'm on my way. Up paste. Just die. You are dead. Yeah. Again, we died because death like that. Okay, so let's put the ship somewhere where it won't happen. What did I just say? Add. Wait, through time and space. Ads right now are fine. It's not like it's going to disrupt anything. You can sleep at the fire for a couple minutes to speed up time. Oh, really? Is there somewhere I can, like, safely put the, somewhere I can safely put the ship? I'll wait, like, 5 minutes. assuming that the clock in this game is like in real time. Obviously not right now because it wants to speed it up, so you're not just sitting here in real time doing nothing. But like when you're playing, it's in real time. So I think we found that one thing that was like the world, not the world, but the sun will explode in like 20 minutes. Yeah. An Ash twin. Not in that direction though. You know that's all right. Rather not do that to myself. Sir, you are hurtling straight into the sun again. But what can I say? I'm a bit of a risk taker. Maybe if I put it on the side, the way that it travels, slightly on the side so that way it doesn't get caught in the sand. Giant sand pillar of doom. Then it'll be okay. Sure you don't want to fly through the sun to get there? Well, consider it, you know, maybe. After much consideration, I've decided no, I don't want to fly into the sun. But I considered it this time. Maybe if I like stick it down here or something. Seems a little bit more stable, and I don't think it could get as far. Just right around in there. Good ship. Get your suit. Also, hi, Tor. How you doing? Oh, we wait again. Well, it's about halfway through, and then we go in. Ah, shit. I went too fast again. I'm too quick. Well, that's okay. No. This is not okay anymore. Aha. Vital's critical. You know. But I lived. Aha. Ow. Oh, the pain. Oh, the pain. Did the ship move? Oh, the ship held on. Good for you, ship. Well, we certainly didn't die, but look at all that red. We are very hurt. Ugh. Imagine, this will be the thing that takes us the longest to do on this stream. And remember, once we finish this, I'll do another one of those view variety things, so that way one of you gets to pick what game we play next out of your variety games. We have the one that Rand suggested, which is still on there. Yeah, we have space for one more. Also, I'm going to start doing ultimate rating again soon. But I'm not going to be streaming those sessions, so streams will either be earlier in the day, or I won't be streaming as often as I was, just because I don't really feel like streaming just raid content. I'd rather, you know, stream stuff like this for you guys. So I think our schedule is supposed to be Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, but Wednesdays I can still do stuff every other week, at least. Thursdays and Fridays I might be able to do stuff for a few hours, but not nearly as long as I have been. You know, that is what it is. I'm so good at getting it the second time. Did you guys clear DSR? We did not clear DSR. We are at... So we got up to the midway point of the sixth phase, but we don't have our ranged anymore. Person who's been doing it with us in our Savage group right now doesn't have any interest in doing it. And the person that we had doing it with us isn't interested in doing raiding anymore at all. They're just burnt out from Final Fantasy completely, so they have no interest in anything like raiding. And the same goes for our healer. They're in a different static now. And they agreed to help us with DSR, but that was it. So after DSR's over, we're getting a new healer and a new ranged DPS. Well, physical ranged. Yeah, I know. Because I enjoy like interacting with you guys a lot, and I can't do the same interactions. What makes me sad. Man. I guess ship got blown away because there's less sand now. Alright, well, let's make it back there without breaking our legs. Uh-oh. We're gonna die. Yeah. Oh, okay. My ship, I'm coming. Ship. Ship, wait for me. Ship. Ship. Ship, don't you forget about me. Ship. Ship, it's me. Told you I wouldn't leave you behind. Let's go. Come on, ship. I don't know what this thing is gonna do or what we're doing with it. We're taking it with us. Let's go. The music when you have this is so cool. Okay, ship. I'm stupid. Where do we go? Go this way. Thank goodness it's not directly into the sun. I just hope you guys get someone who has pure TDD energy, because honestly that's why I enjoyed watching your raid. TDD is my kind of funny. Oh, good. Hey, Oceano. I really do enjoy this music a lot that I'm hearing. Like, it just sounds nice. It really does make you feel like whatever you're doing with this warp core is something that you need to be doing. If that makes any sense. Alright, so I want to be... I don't want to listen to that frequency. I want to listen to the distress beacon. Hey, Jer.
Jerby 11 creeping.
How you doing, Jer? Thanks, Oceano. Glad to see you brave the anglerfish. Yeah, look at me. I'm braving them. So brave now. All because of Oceano. Big brave boy. Is the core of this thing, so I can shoot the whatchamacallit into it. Really a dumb thing that I'm doing. Oh, Scott, you're supposed to go in the hole. Okay. Get out of my way! I showed you how to unexist the funky fish. You know what would make them okay is if they had cool hip sunglasses on and like a Hawaiian t-shirt. Maybe that would make them a little bit more bearable. Wrong way. Gotta follow Lance. Go this way. Yeah. Alright, then we insert this here. Oh. Whoa. Orb. Okay. And No. Go that way. Go that way. Good. Back here. Football. Is that? Where are we? Wait. Like death to me. Here. This. Ground looks like something out of Rayman. Where the heck am I? Black hole, sun. The gravity's here is very dense. Oh. Black hole, sun. They're already blind, why would they wear sunglasses? To make them look hip and cool. The heck am I? He's detected oxygen tank refilled. The heck am I? Question, where are your hats? Not with me. Where am I? Where am I going? At least my flashlight works in here. Oh, this reminds me of that rock that kept disappearing. That's a good question. I didn't get rid of my hats. They're all just in bags right now. Question for chat, where do I go? Cosplay as Mabel Twin Sorix. Yeah, you're right. Somewhere in nowhere. Well, this is definitely somewhere. The map on the left of the screen. It? Compass. Yeah. If I just keep going forward? You can just blow a hole into the surface of Mars. I know where you need to go, I just can't see it. This place is very interesting, though. I hope I'm not on a timer. Right south? Am I going south or north right now? I would like to imagine that this is north, so I'm going to turn around. Weast. Weast it is. That's weast. I guess. One thing I wish this game had was better lighting. I mean, I have a flashlight. You like the flashlight? Here, take the flashlight. Grab my flashlight. Like how the tree just showed up, went, "Sup, Brett," and it disappeared. Whoa. They are appearing and disappearing. Yeah. Earth? Like... Gravity stopped working here. You know what? I don't know if I want to go up that way. Can't even get it back. The worst that could happen. You know what? You're right. Come here. Going into you. Giant bottomless void. No. Hey. Am I going to see Cthulhu? What? Outer Wilds Ventures was founded by Feldspar, Gossen, Slate, and Hornfels to explore a solar system at the end of the universe. I'm gonna turn up the volume. Oh, you're finally awake! Is this a Skyrim parody? Is this why people love this so much? It's gonna lead to Skyrim? Am I gonna start hearing like dragon music? And then I'm just gonna hear No mind ever got to see it for themselves, but thanks to their efforts and technology, Ahrathian was able to reach the eye of the universe. Flashlight, good. You know, Annapurna, the environment and everything that you set up, I'm very excited now for Silent Hill. They're working on Silent Hill, or a Silent Hill game, and I am very excited for that, considering what this is. At the end of its lifespan, our sun collapsed under its own gravity and then exploded into a violent supernova. Yeah, that Silent Hill game is going to look good if it's made by these people. All the life forms who will perish in the oncoming death of the universe, we will miss the anglerfish the least. When 100% agreed. Get out of here, you stinky ass anglerfish, you piece of shit. Can't fight back anymore because you got modded out of existence thanks to Oceano. No one likes you. No one. An Omai who came to our solar system were following a signal from the Eye of the Universe. It perished when the Interloper arrived, bringing with it the deadly substance we called ghost matter that flooded the entire solar system almost instantly and without warning. Oh, so that's what ended up killing everybody. Ghost matter from Interloper. Anything else I can look at up here? Otherwise, I guess we'll observe the... this. Sure. Goodbye. Peace. Peace. And then these all turn into anglerfish. Oh. Oh. Oh, I'm sorry. Music. What's that? Imagine playing this without any sound. Oh, they're all gone. My scout's still gone. Also, hi, Roxas. Sorry I didn't say hi. Where am I going? Oh. There was a signal. I was just kind of holding this out and hoping that I would find something. There was. Hear Isaac Clarke breathing. But that was me. Now it's a tree. Kinda nonsense. Time to eat a marshmallow. How'd you do that? How'd you do that? You hear music? How'd you know that? Who are you? Who? Are you scared of the friendly Esker? No. Scared of the fact that he showed up here. How do you do that? Pedal faster, I hear banjos. Oh no, not banjos. Please. So if I didn't have any fuel. Banjo. 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 I'm not gonna mod out Esker. At least brave that, Zyro. So I hear music, Esker, but I can't reach it. Coming back. I have to do that, in which case I'll turn around, but yeah. Yeah, I guess I have to go find a way to get in there. Wait a minute. Hey, look at that. There's a trick of the lights. Oh. Ow. So whatever I see here is not real, but real. It's not quite time yet. Pretty sure we'll need the others for this next part. We'll need, you know, everyone. No rush, take your time. Aren't you forgetting someone? Oh, apparently I'm forgetting a bunch of people. Go get him. Quiet Shade. Cross Old Bark. Ancient Glade. It's always dark. Oh. Aha! No, 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 no. I don't appreciate that. I feel like that's going to lead to a jump scare at some point. Right now they're just flickering the lights. A jump scare in this game? Never. Yeah, I'm sure. That one's weird. I knew it. I knew it. So that's what it looks like up close. I hate that. Blech. Blech. Just a friendly fish. Friendly. Didn't even try to eat you. Oh, thank goodness. Figured if it was gonna eat me, it would have been a lot sooner, which is why I also stood still. Hello. See. was neat. What do you say then? Should I get out the old harmonica? Yeah. Aha, here goes nothing. Ready to start the music? Yep. Should I begin? Yeah. You got it, I'll do my best. Can't wait to play with the whole group again. Can I start? Yep. Okay, I won't let you down. We did it. Hi, Senri. Hey, Apasha. We did it. We got the actual credits. That was fun. So I'm assuming that we broke the cycle and QD alert. Oh, me. Doing that again. That was a fun game. Once I removed the anglerfish, seeing it like that, ooh, now I know what it actually looks like up close. Yeah, I'm happy I never had to actually see it again. No. Thank you. Not a fan. You're still trapped. You created a new universe. Oh, I saw him a god. Bye, Havasia. That was fun, though. Even though I didn't really see everything that the game had. I just saw the notes about the warp core, went, okay, we're taking this thing. And then we went and, Dark Bramble? Grabbed that. And I saw the thing about the vessel, and I was like, okay, let's go check out this vessel. And then it was like, oh, there's a warp core thing here. Stuck that in there, and then it led me here. Made your own ending, and that's what counts. Yeah. Isn't that what it's about? The experience. One devoid of anglerfish. Fact about the music. Yeah. A world with no anglerfish. One man. Won't be afraid of the anglerfish. Vocalist. Annapurna Interactive, they're working on Silent Hill now. And it's going to be fantastic because if they went... Okay, so fun fact, people that didn't know this. Star Rift, at the beginning of the main menu, they made that when they started development. Second one. Oh, nice. This is some, like, just little horror game stuff. You guys know Five Nights at Freddy's? The creator Is Annapurna only a publisher, not a game developer? Yeah. Not the publisher, not the devs of the game. Yeah, yeah, sorry. But still, Annapurna is being in charge of that, so it's going to be quality. But Five Nights at Freddy's, the guy who made Five Nights at Freddy's, he originally just went into like game design to do like a lot more religious games. But people always talked about how creepy his like designs looked and everything. So then that's why he ended up making Five Nights at Freddy's. I got the same vibe when I saw the anglerfish. I'm like, oh, this game's beautiful. It's so nice. Then I saw that, I'm like, nightmare fuel. And by the way, 2 out of 6. I don't think I can do anything about that during this. Nope, credit's gonna roll. Credit's gonna roll. I can't stop it. Unless... take that, credits. We have this tool called Tab Out. Tab Out tool. Saved us. Thank you, Tab Out. How'd you get so many ads, Reed? I should never install the mods for Subnautica. What are the ads? What are the mods? Are the ads done? Everybody? Can you hear me? You already timed out a fish for 999,999 seconds. Alright, so a story for you. For people that didn't know this, when it comes to fish. Talking about this thing called the gulper. You know, in Monster Hunter 3, the one that had the underwater combat, how they had the gobble? Yeah, I finished the game. Wanted to leave more fish, yeah. So, I finished the game. I completely finished it. Finished the ending, everything. Beat all the elder dragons and everything. All the water combat. But the gobble was the only one I never beat. Until I had the max G rank armor. And so I went into a normal fight with the gobble and I destroyed it. Reason why is because I just never wanted to. I saw what it looked like and I was like, I have no interest in this fish. Stay away from me. I do not want to fight that. Well, gobble was a key quest. I didn't have to go and do it. My friends did it for me. We went into a multiplayer lobby to catch me up. They beat it and I just sort of sat around and didn't do anything. It was great. What about the nibble snarf? Nibble snarf, I don't mind. It's strange. It's if they're underwater, it terrifies me. Nibble snarf on its own, fine. I thought it was adorable. Like I always talked about the way it looked. I'm like, oh. A lot of years later, 14.3 billion. Hey. My universe is pretty poppin'. Top quality universe. It's our scout. They're just traveling through space.
Space. Space.
Yay! Yay! You can see my mouse because I'm happy. That was my probe from earlier that went missing. Thank you, little probe. You did this. Made this possible. Man, that was fun. Thank you, Otter Wilds, for all the fun.